Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Apple series. My name is Carl Pullein, and this week it's all about using Siri with reminders. Now, Siri works with many of Apple's built-in features. It can actually work well with a lot of third-party applications, although some of those I've not had a lot of luck with, but certainly with the built-in Apple applications, Siri is a fantastic tool to use. Now, this week, what I want to do is focus on the Reminders app and using the right kind of words to get Siri to totally understand exactly what it is you want her to do for you. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to ask, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks and news on using Apple's applications, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me now take you into my Apple Reminders with a little help from Siri and show you just some of the wonderful things you can do with Siri and Reminders. Okay, so here we are with my Reminders app open. And for those of you who've been following me for a while, you know all about my time sector system. This is just a demo account. This is my old phone. But I can show you how to use Siri to get the most out of your Reminders app. And there's a few things that you just need to be aware of. So let's just take a simple example. And this is how I actually use Reminders on a day-to-day basis. If you can see down at the bottom, I've got a shopping list. Now, my shopping list is not part of the time sector system, but I do use Reminders very much for my shopping list. So what I can do is something like, "Hey Siri, add broccoli to my shopping list."
All right, I've added it to your shopping list.
So now what you'll see is in my shopping list, I have broccoli. And this is a fantastic use for Reminders, particularly if you're like me and you actually use a different kind of to-do list manager. On my day-to-day life, I use an application called Todoist, but I do actually use my shopping list is actually in my Reminders app, because I can share that with my wife. And actually, while I'm cooking, I don't usually have my phone with me, but I actually use my Apple Watch to do the same thing, and it adds this into there. Now, the thing about adding a task to a specific list, you do have to be very clear about the list. So for example, I could say, "Hey Siri, add call Jeff to my this week's list."
Which list should I add it to? This week or next week? Done.
So this is why you've got to be very careful about how you actually say the word. So as you can see, I've got call Jeff written into this week. So you've got to be very, very clear about how you're going to do it. Now, those are just the basic ones, but now you can start getting a little bit clever. So for example, "Hey Siri, remind me to buy milk tomorrow morning."
Reminder is set for tomorrow at 7 o'clock.
So what Siri has done is she has, oops, I've gone into my calendar. Let's already go back into my Reminders app. So what Siri has done is she identifies my task morning as meaning 7 a.m. So if I do another one, "Hey Siri, remind me to call Sarah tomorrow afternoon."
Is set for tomorrow at noon.
So what Siri is doing there is she is interpreting my morning at 7 a.m. and she's interpreting the afternoon as lunchtime 12 p.m. So I could also add, "Hey Siri, remind me to call Mum tomorrow evening."
Okay, your reminder is set for tomorrow at 1800 hours.
So basically what we have is evening time, Siri is interpreting that as 6 p.m. Lunch, afternoon time, she's interpreting it as 12. So really basically at the very beginning of the day. So these are some of the things that you can do. Now, let's just take another example. If I go into Safari, we'll just randomly pick, we've got a Doist here. So let's just take this. Let's just say, as I'm doing as I'm going through this, I think, oh yeah, I want to, so I could sort of copy this. Use to do is to organize your life or work. So let's just say I want to get that. And what I can do now from there is, come up, please. What I can do from that is I can go into share. So I'm going to share that to my reminders app. So I can just do that. And I can just add that task. Now, what you'll find is that's come up now as plan ahead with Todoist, upcoming view, a spacious way to view tasks. So we've got that there, but what it's actually also done is it's added the link to the part that I copied. And that's one of the cool things about using reminders. It is actually a very, very robust to-do list manager. And there's a couple of other things that you can do. So for example, hey Siri, remind me to cook dinner when I get home.
Okay, your reminder is set.
So what you can see now is I've got a what we call a geo-fenced here. Siri knows my home address. So now when I arrive home, that I'm going to get this reminder to cook dinner. Now, of course, if you're working in an office, you can actually geo-fence your office so that you can actually add tasks to that one. So those are just some of the things that you can do with Siri to remind yourself to actually do sort of a task as they come up. And it's just a really, really good way of using Siri to quickly add tasks into your reminders. And it's something I see a lot of people actually forget things to do. Another one that you could do is just one more, and let's just go into just find a task in here. Do we have a link in here? We don't have a so let's just go to this one in Todoist. So I could just now, hey Siri, remind me about this when I get home.
Okay, your reminder is set.
So what I've actually done here is, if I now go back into my Todoist, that particular article will now be, I will be reminded of that when I get home. Now you could do this, obviously, remind me about this when I get back to the office. And you can do this with email as well. So I don't know if I've actually got an email in here, because this is not, I don't know if, the, oh yeah. So let's just say I've opened this email. I can say, hey Siri, remind me about this email tomorrow morning.
Okay, your reminder is set for tomorrow at 7 o'clock.
So what I've got now is, if I go back to my reminders, I can actually see this. This is going to come up. And as you can see, there is a link directly to the email. There's a link to the Safari web page. You know, Apple Reminders is such a powerful to-do list system because it's actually built into your whole Apple ecosystem. So whether you're using an iPad or whether you're using an iPhone, you can just get Siri to remind you about these things. And these are just some of those little amazing little features that you can use with Apple's Reminders app. You can actually do this with notes as well. You can say, hey Siri, just add this to my notes app. Yeah, she's not going to find a matching note. But anyway, you can actually create all sorts of things doing that. So hopefully you found this useful. I strongly recommend that you have a play around with Siri and using reminders. It can save you so much time, particularly when if you're using the iPad Pro with the keyboard. It's almost like having your own MacBook, but it's using the iOS system. It's such a powerful way of getting stuff into your reminders app. So there you go. Thank you very much for watching this episode. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you for watching this video. Now, if you have enjoyed these Apple videos that I'm doing and you want to build your very own Apple productivity system, then please check out my Create Your Own Apple Productivity System course, which is available from my Learning Center and is incredible value, and it will show you how to bring all these parts together, the Notes app, iCloud, Reminders and Calendar, into one beautiful productivity system. Check out the course here. The details are below, and I hope to see you in the course.